Okay, for the second method, the trigonometry method, okay, we have r equal to p plus q, or you can use q plus p, same. So we use the trigonometry. The first step is same, but for the graphical method, first and second step will be same, only the last one, instead of measure, we have to calculate. Okay, so the first step, I want to put in here, this is the r, I didn't know, this is the, we didn't know, okay? The two magnitude of this one we didn't know. Okay, but what I want here is we will have the P, which is 10 Newton. Direction is 30 degree. Q is 20. Direction is 40 degree. Okay, what you want to do is you want also to draw the figure for this one, but instead of drawing exactly at the same scale, same length and direction, you have to draw approximately correct, okay, not to the scale but it must be near correct to the real one. So let's say I'm using this one P first, so this is the start point 10, so I have this one as 10. Let's say I have this one P equal to 10, so this is 30 degree, and then I'm adding 40 degree must be here, so 1 and 2, because this one is 30, this one is 10, this one is 20, so I have 20 Newton here. Okay, this direction, so I have, this is the start point, this is the end point, so the value must be from here to here, this is the R and this is the theta. Okay, you see that this is the same figure by the other one, the first one that we do, but only it is not as correct as before. I'm not measuring, but I'm just drawing that approximately correct. Okay, meaning that what I mean by approximately is if we have 30 degree here, you will not draw this is as 30 degree. So this is wrong. This is not 30 degree, this is wrong. Okay, 30 degree, the 45 is in the middle, so this might be your 30 degree. This is what I mean by approximately correct. If this is 10, this is 20, so I'm expecting this is 2 times from this one. Because if you are drawing this one really not correct, maybe your 30 degree is here. Okay, this is the P, and then your Q is, so you are doing, instead of this is 40, but your 40 is this one, okay, 40, so your answer must be this one. You will see that your theta is already different angle than this one, much, much different, so you will not have the correct answer, okay. The theta is not at the same quadrant as this one, okay, so you must draw approximately correct. This is the first step. And to answer this one, you have to calculate using sine and cosine rule. So you have to remember the sine and cosine rule. Okay, so let's say this is A, the angle inside is A, B angle inside here is B, C angle inside here is C. So this is A angle in front of it, B angle in front of it, C angle in front of it. Okay, so you have the first one is sine rule. Sine rule where it said that the sin A divided by A equal to sin B divided by B equal to sin C divided by C, and you have the cosine rule, okay, which stated that let's say we take the A, okay, so A squared equal to B squared plus C squared minus 2 DC, so cos the opposite one, this one, cos A. So A squared equal to B squared plus C squared minus 2BC, cos A. So you have to remember these two equations in order for you to solve this problem. Okay, for example here, we didn't know this one, okay, but we already know the length of this is 20, this is 10, and the angle inside here we already know, so you can use cosine rule. Okay, so directly we use the cosine rule. But first of all, you must put the all the angle that is known, this is 30, so zigzag here must also be 30. So 40 plus 30 here is 70 degree. Okay, 70 degree. So what we can do now is we can use the cosine rule RSA. So R squared equal to B squared. Let's say we take this is as B, 20 squared plus 10 squared minus 20 cos 70 degree. Okay, so calculate that one, you will have RS. I've already calculated that one. So what is the R? My R is 19.06 newton. Okay, so this is your R. So now you know the value of for R, 19 point something. Okay, this is the R. This is only the magnitude of the R. We want to know also the magnitude and also the direction. So we need to know the theta. Okay, and we can use the sine rule now. Okay, or if you want to use the cosine also, you can use the cosine rule, because we can take this one and then we get the angle theta here. Okay, the opposite direction. So opposite, make it as 20 here and we have cos theta here. We want this one, but we can only calculate the length of this one and the angle inside, which is this one is beta, for example, this one is alpha. You can only calculate the angle inside this one. So you have to calculate first the angle inside and then you will minus the all component to get the theta. Because from here you can see that here you have 30 plus the angle inside here, alpha plus theta equal to 180 newton. Okay, so this whole thing is 180 newton. Okay, so you want now to calculate what is alpha. Minus from everything, then you get the theta. Okay, so you can use cosine or you can also use the sine rule. For example, use the sine. Okay, you can use the sine. Let's say we use the sine alpha. This one divided by the length of this one divided by 20 equal to sine. The angle that I already know here is 70. So sine 70. Divided by the R already calculated, minus 19.06. So you have the alpha equal to, so calculate this one. If you have sine 70 equal to divided by minus 19.86 equal to times 20 equal to, and then you want to have sine alpha equal to this one. So alpha equal to sine minus 1. So sine minus 1, this answer, so you have 80.4 degree. Alpha is 80.4 degree. Okay, now you get the alpha, you want to have the theta. So you have to minus from everything. Theta equal to, this is 180. 80 minus this one, 30. Plus this one, 80.4. So you have 180 minus answer minus 30. You have 69.6 degrees. 69.6 degrees. This is your answer for direction. So your final answer, you must write R equal to 19.06 newton, 69.6 degree. So this is your final answer. Okay, you must write in terms of magnitude and also the direction. Okay, if you don't write the final answer into this one, we will deduct some mark from your result. Okay, from your answer.